Hello friends, welcome to another video of Indian Heroes. Here we will talk about Captain Lakshmi Sahgal, a lady who inspired millions. Born as Lakshmi Swaminadhan on 24 October 1914, she broke social conventions and dogmas from a very early age, speaking out against the caste practices in Kerala. Sahgal was witness to the freedom struggle with her mother, A.V. Ammukutty, a social activist and a freedom fighter who would later become a member of the Constituent Assembly. Sahgal completed her studies in medicine from the Madras Medical College in 1938. With the outbreak of the Second World War, most doctors were being recruited to serve for the imperialist forces. However, Sahgal went to Singapore and initiated her medical practice there, taking care of the Indian diaspora along with several Chinese and Malay patients. She joined the Indian Independence League formed by veteran freedom fighter Raj Bihari Bose in 1941. By 1943, the leadership of the League was taken over by Subhash Chandra Bose, along with that of the INA, which was formed in February 1942 by Captain Mohan Singh and other Indian prisoners of war. Sahgal was drawn to this movement by Bose's charismatic leadership. He played an active role in the formation of the All-Women Infantry Regiment of the INA, named after the famous Rani of Jhansi, who fought the British Raj in 1857. Thereafter, Dr. Lakshmi Swaminadhan would become Captain Lakshmi, leading to the conflation of a lifelong identity with historical events. She was the only woman member of the cabinet of the Provisional Government of the Azad Hind, led by Bose. After her arrest in 1945, she was brought back to India. In 1947, she married Colonel Prem Kumar Sahgal, who served along with her in the INA. In the post-independence era, Sahgal resumed her medical practice in Kanpur. She worked among the refugees of post-partition India. She joined CPM in 1971 and remained an active member till the end of her life. During the Bangladesh War of 1971, she travelled to Kolkata and worked in the border areas of Bongao for 6 weeks, providing medical help to the displaced and the migrants. Sahgal was the founding member of the All India Democratic Women's Association, which was formed in 1981. The organization became a suitable platform for her to raise women's issues consistently and embarked on several campaigns for the same. In 1984, she went to Bhopal with a medical team after the gas tragedy. Her commitment to secular values in the face of adversity was displayed on numerous occasions. She confronted frenzied mobs during the anti-Sikh riots of 1984 on the streets of Kanpur, ensuring the safety of Sikhs in and around her clinic. Sahgal dedicated her life to the country and its people. She looked for opportunities to contribute without thinking of the consequences. She continued to look after patients in Kanpur till the age of 92, as she charged a very minimal fee or sometimes nothing at all. There would always be a queue of patients waiting for her outside her clinic. She would herself clean the space outside her clinic and did most of her work on her own. She became the joint candidate for the left parties in the presidential elections of 2002 and ran against APJ Abdul Kalam. Although she lost the election, she spent a number of days traversing the length and breadth of the country, addressing a number of rallies. She died on July 19, 2012 due to a cardiac arrest at the age of 97 in Kanpur. Her body was donated to Kanpur Medical College for medical research. She was also awarded the Padma Vibhushan, the second highest civilian award, by the then Indian president, K.R. Narayan. Though she is no more alive, but her memory will always be alive till eternity. Hope you like the video. Please subscribe us for more such videos. Thank you.